Long pause. I do believe in God. Who lets these things happen? She raised herself on her arm and thrust her argument at him with her hand. Who kills my Teddy and your Hugh and millions? No, said Mr. Britling. But he must let these things happen, or why do they happen? No, said Mr. Britling. It is the theologians who must answer that. They have been extravagant about God. They have had silly absolute ideas that he is all-powerful, that he's omni-everything. But the common sense of men knows better. Every real religious thought denies it. After all, the real God of the Christians is Christ, not God Almighty. A poor, mocked and wounded God nailed on a cross of matter. Some day he will triumph. But it is not fair to say that he causes all things now. It is not fair to make out a case against him. You have been misled. It is a theologian's folly. God is not absolute. God is finite. A finite God who struggles in his great and comprehensive way, as we struggle in our weak and silly way, who is with us. That is the essence of all real religion. I agree with you so. Why, if I thought there was an omnipotent God who looked down on battles and deaths and all the waste and horror of this war, able to prevent these things, doing them to amuse himself, I would spit in his empty face. Anyone would. But it's your teachers and catechisms have set you against God. They want to make out he owns all nature, and all sorts of silly claims, like the heralds in the Middle Ages, who insisted that Christ was certainly a great gentleman entitled to bear arms.